His name is Gonzalo Curiel. The judge, who happens to be, we believe, Mexican, which is great. I think that's fine. You know what? I think the Mexicans are going to end up loving Donald Trump when I give all these jobs.
Now, it is unprecedented for a presidential candidate to call into question a judge's integrity by insinuating he's Mexican. And for the record, Judge Curiel was born in Indiana and attended Indiana University. With me now to talk about this and more is Republican strategist and Trump surrogate Boris Epshteyn, CNN commentator and Clinton supporter Bakari Sellers, and the director for the Center of Politics at the University of Virginia, Larry Sabato. Welcome to all of you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Good morning.
Larry, what do you make of what Donald Trump said?
Well, he knows in all probability those documents are going to be embarrassing to him. They're going to contain material that will be fodder for the Democrats. You know, Carol, I just got to say this. For a guy who has a terrible problem with Hispanics, virtually every survey has him with support levels in the 20s or even in the teens with Hispanics. To call this judge, quote, Mexican, when in fact he is a U.S. citizen born in the United States in 1953, doesn't help him at all. It's like the attack on Governor Susana Martinez in New Mexico. Totally unnecessary, doesn't help him at all. He does it anyway.
Boris, why does he go there?
Well, I can't speak for why Donald Trump said something. But as far as the whole Trump University attack goes, you know, it's been out there for a long time now, and it doesn't work. So we already saw it fail in the primaries, right? It's been brought up since about January or February. So politically, it is not necessarily fodder for the Democrats. It is something that's a civil suit. It's not a
well, again,
a then,
if it's not fodder
it
for the Democrats,
the level
but Boris, if it's not fodder for the Democrats and it hurts him with a certain demographic group in America, why go there?
Well, we have to see whether it hurts or not, right? You have to do polling on a specific question to determine whether that specific statement hurt. And I would proffer that it probably does not, because Donald Trump is shown to be a very strong candidate who is not hurt by certain statements that some people disagree with.
Bakari, your take?
Well, I think that this just it's in a long line of and pattern of Donald Trump saying things that offend minority voters. And one thing Donald Trump has to do is broaden his base. Donald Trump has been very successful in running up extremely high numbers of white voters in the Republican primary. However, if he's going to win in the Southwest and in places like Arizona or Nevada, or if he's going to win in the South in places like North Carolina or Florida, or even in the Rust Belt in Ohio, Pennsylvania, he has to expand that base and he has to start wooing minority voters to the Republican Party. The reason that down ballot candidates on the Republican side are terrified of Donald Trump is because on today, a day like Memorial Day, he made a statement about POWs a few months ago, and now he's talking about Mexican judges. So, I mean, this is just a long pattern of what will Donald Trump say next.
Well, Larry, you know, Donald Trump has this fraud case against Trump University, right? And Hillary Clinton has this email controversy. Do they neutralize each other? I mean, what's more damaging to which candidate, or don't voters care?
Well, I think voters do care. The Republicans care about the fact that Hillary Clinton appears to be dishonest and untrustworthy, and the Democrats care about the fact that Donald Trump appears to be dishonest and untrustworthy. That's why they both have very high, sky-high unfavorables. They've got to figure out how to use this material, given the fact that neither one is very credible attacking the other's honesty and integrity. Probably they will want to leave some of that to surrogates.
Listen, as far as this goes, one side, Hillary Clinton's emails are under federal investigation by the FBI. The inspector general just came out of the Secretary of State with a report saying that she absolutely went against the policies of the Secretary of State, of the State Department, right? The Trump thing is a civil suit. So the two absolutely are not equal. Hillary Clinton's problem is much deeper and much worse. It goes against absolutely all her credibility as Secretary of State, and that's what she's running on. Not only was she a terrible Secretary of State, she didn't even follow the policies of the State Department.
Bakari, he's right about that. Hillary Clinton is under a federal investigation, and it is a civil suit brought against Trump University.
Well, it is. You're right. I mean, if you want to look at just the plain facts, one is a civil suit and one is an investigation. But the fact of the matter is that Hillary Clinton followed the same protocol that Colin Powell followed. I mean, this is not
incorrect, Bakari.
This is not anything new. And you know, the investigation is going to shake out, and we'll have an answer to that sooner rather than later, we hope. And everything looks to be that Hillary Clinton's going to be cleared of any wrongdoing or criminal wrongdoing. With that being said, we started this conversation talking about the brashness of Donald Trump. And we have these moments, whether or not it's this Trump University, whether or not it's his casinos and the Taj Mahal that's coming under the bankruptcy filings, which are going to be released sooner as well, or anything that will happen next week with Donald Trump. I mean, I think that is the point. He is so unpredictable, and he's proven to be a con artist that we don't know what's going to happen next with Donald Trump.
Hold on. Previous secretaries of state have done the same is just incorrect. And no, it's been proven to be incorrect. Colin Powell had a separate email, not a separate server. Different.
And Colin Powell used a separate email to conduct State Department business. That's a
but
fact.
But not a separate server where half the emails have disappeared. Different. Already in Washington Post stated that's a lie.
There has been no Secretary of State, and Hillary Clinton has come forward and provided 55,000 emails. 55,000. There's been no Secretary of State. There's been no one who has actually done that. And while we're on this, what about
30,000 emails have not been provided.
While we're on this, what about Donald Trump and his taxes? I mean, when are we going to talk about the fact that this individual has not even put forth his taxes because he says the American public...
There's no federal law or obligation to put forth your taxes. Well, Hillary Clinton is under a federal investigation, and she has to be more
I hear both of you. I'm going to go to the neutral party now, Larry. When you listen to these arguments, is this what voters are going to be wrestling with? Or, you know, are Republican voters who are for Donald Trump, they don't care? And are Democratic voters who are for Hillary Clinton, they don't care? Is that it?
Carol, these two very articulate fellows are giving us a taste of the scorched earth campaign that is to come. There is an embarrassment of riches on both sides for attack material, and we will be hearing all of it ad nauseum all the way to November 8th, Election Day.
That's probably true. Larry Sabato, Boris Epshteyn, Bakari Sellers, thanks to all of you. I appreciate
it. Thank you. Thanks so much. Have a great day.